Good evening, everybody. It is time for us to begin our papers. I'm George Mathew from the Martha Syrian Church, who is specialized in liturgy, a student of the Pauruste Vidya Vedam, the Oriental Institute, Pontifical Oriental Institute, Badavadur, and did my doctoral studies with Father Jacob and specialized in the Eucharistic liturgy. To begin with, today's moderator, Dr. Abdo Badawi, Sister Dr. Ann, Dr. Gabi, respected fathers, sisters, and dear friends. Today I'm going to present the paper, A Study of the Order of the Consecration of the Holy Moron in the Martha Syrian Church. This paper is divided into three parts: the tradition of the consecration of the Holy Moron in general, the text of the consecration and practice and its preparation, thirdly, the theology of the consecration based on the liturgical text of the consecration of the Holy Moron in the Martha Syrian Church. Introduction. Martha Church is an Eastern Reformed Church which follows the West Syrian Antiochian liturgical tradition. The Church has the long tradition of using the Holy Moron for the consecration of baptismal water, post-baptismal anointing, consecration of the church, and consecration of tabelitho. The order of the consecration of Holy Moron is not studied in a scholarly manner because of various reasons. The text is not translated into English and other languages, and there was no easy access to the text. In this study, an attempt is being made to translate the text into English from the vernacular Malayalam, and a textual analysis is made to elucidate the theology of the consecration of Holy Moron and the practice of anointing with holy oil, the tradition of consecration. In the West Syrian liturgical tradition, two types of oil is applied for baptism. Olive oil is applied for the baptismal anointing, and Holy Moron is used for the consecration of the baptismal water and post-baptismal anointing. The Greek word moron denotes the perfumed oil, incense, scent, etc. Similar meaning is given in the New Testament. The practice of anointing with holy oil during and after baptism were prevailed in the Syrian churches. Consecration of Holy Moron during the time of baptismal service itself was the practice of the Syrian church before AD 400. There were references about the consecration of Holy Moron during the time of baptism in the Syriac documents like the Acts of Thomas and Apostolic Constitutions. When special importance were received for the consecration of oil, the consecration took place separately. From the 5th century onwards, it was the practice of the Syrian churches to consecrate the Holy Moron during the Passover Thursday. It is continued during the period of Barabraeus, the Catholicos of the East. By this, the holy oil was made available to the baptism conducted during the Easter Sunday. It is believed that the present text for the consecration is composed by Michael the Great, the Patriarch of Antioch. The detailed description of the consecration of the Holy Moron was given by Dionysius Areopagite. According to him, it is the Moron which gives perfection to all hierarchical consecration. He further comments that Moron is used for the post-baptismal anointing, consecration of baptismal water, consecration of the church and altar. Moron is consecrated by the head of the church along with the assistance of all the bishops. It can be consecrated according to the needs of the church, says Jacob of Edessa. Detailed references are given in the footnote. Number two, the text and practice of consecration. The text used in the Martha Syrian Church is very ancient, which follows the West Syrian liturgical tradition. There is a printed version in Malayalam known as Moron Kudasha, or Consecration of Holy Moron. Structure of the text. The service begins with the traditional adoration or kauma, the container of the holy oil which has to be consecrated, placed on the tabelitho, the wooden plank on which the holy elements are placed during the holy kurbana. There are two prayers in which Christ is addressed as the true fragrance who surrendered himself for the salvation of humankind. It also beseeches God to accept the members of the Holy Church as a spiritual sacrifice. Then Psalm 84 is read out, where the beauty of the temple of God is depicted. The next two prayers are addressed to Christ, the true Messiah, and beseech to make the faithful holy, righteous, and enable them to stand at his presence in the end. lections or readings. Readings are taken from Psalms, Exodus 30, 1 John chapter 2, 22, chapter 3, verse 1, Gospel Saint Matthew 26, 6 to 13. In these texts, various anointing in the Old Testament and New Testament and how to prepare oil of anointing in the Old Testament is elaborated, which shows the scriptural foundation of the consecration of the holy oil. The Nicene Creed is recited by the congregation and in the following prayers, the gift of the Holy Spirit is sought to sanctify and consecrate the holy oil. The second prayer is titled as the prayer for the gift of the Holy Spirit. In the Promion and Sadhara, the divine act of God through Christ is well narrated. The final prayer is a prayer of consecration, and all the bishops lay their hands on the container and beseech God to sanctify the holy oil. The invocation is in the name of the Holy Trinity. The service ends with the adoration of the Trinity, Lord's Prayer, benediction by the Metropolitan, the head of the church. Now the preparation of the holy moron. Ingredients for moron preparation: olive oil, sandalwood oil, sandalwood, joss sticks or incense, saffron, camphor, clove, cinnamon, shellac, tender leaves of teak. 2 days before the consecration of moron, it is prepared under the leadership of the Metropolitan, Senior Vicar General, the Sabha Secretary, priests, deacons and lay people also attended that time. When olive oil is boiled in a large vessel, all other ingredients which were powdered and added and mixed with that oil one after another. Camphor and tender leaves of teak are added at a later stage. The whole process of preparation takes about 5 to 6 hours. During the whole time, the mixture is stirred by somebody. After it becomes cold, moron for consecration is poured out into 6 large glass jars. On the day of consecration of moron, all the 6 glass bottles or jars are put on the tabalitha, on the thronos. There is another jar of moron which was brought from Mardin by Matthias Marathanasius. That jar is kept in the middle. During the service, Metropolitan pour out some moron from the bottle from the Mardin to all the 6 bottles and refill it to the 6 bottles after consecration. The service is led by the Metropolitan and all other bishops participate in the service of consecration of moron. Metropolitan in his kappa or his liturgical vestments with a mitre. All other bishops wear their black puram loha or robe. Metropolitan staff was taken by Vicar General. Censer with incense is waved by a priest or a deacon. Lessons from Old Testament and New Testaments are read out by the priest. Metropolitan read out the gospel. Reading of prayers are shared by all bishops. When the sanctification prayer is proclaimed, all bishops lay their right hand on these bottles. A large number of priests and lay people also attend in the service. Metropolitan gives a homily during the service. According to the Metropolitan, in the Marthoma Church, there is not a service for consecration of new moron, but we are only multiplying the moron which was brought from Mardin in 1843 by Matthias Marathanasius after his consecration as Metropolitan by the Patriarch of Antioch. There is a detailed description given in the footnote, which I will read out. Matthias Marathanasius was the 13th Marthoma of the undivided Malankara Church and was the pioneer of the Reformation in the Malankara Syrian Church. He was consecrated by Elias II, Patriarch of Antioch at Mardin, and came back to Malankara in 1843. He also brought the holy moron with him for the use in the Malankara Church. A portion of the holy moron is still kept in the container brought from Mardin, kept at the Pulathin headquarters of the Marthoma Metropolitan. Now the theology of the consecration. In the initial prayer, Jesus Christ himself is considered as the true fragrance to God the Father for the sake of the humankind. By the anointing of the oil of gladness, the children of the church receive the anointing and the seal of the Holy Spirit and praise the triune God. The believers may become acceptable offering as fragrance to the Lord. Jesus Christ is the true Messiah, the anointed one. By this anointing, the believers may become mature, holy and spiritual beings. In the following prayer for the consecration of oil, the intention and purpose of the anointing of the oil is well explained as follows. I quote, "Send us the grace of your Holy Spirit, sanctify and perfect this oil presented before God, make it for the sacramental anointing, fulfillment of God's divine gift, sanctification of the anointed for the glory of God's precious name. In the first part of the prayer for the Holy Spirit, all the attributes of the Holy Spirit or a strong pneumatology is narrated. I quote, "Send us your Holy Spirit, who is comforter, great and life-giving, spoke through the law, prophets and apostles, one who stands nearby, perfects everything, who bestows holiness to whom you please us by your goodwill, not as a servant but like a master, source of divine gifts, diverse in the operation of the gift equal to you in essence, who proceeds from you, being one with you and your only begotten Son in the royal throne." In the second part of this prayer, the effects of the anointing with holy Moroni is well explained as follows. Again, I quote from the prayer book. "Lord, bless and sanctify us and this oil presented before you. Bless all those who will be anointed and sealed by this oil. This holy oil is according to the priestly order. This is royal Moroni. May this be the oil of gladness, cloth of splendor, robe of salvation, protection of life, spiritual gift, holiness of body, mind, and spirit, gladness of the world, imperishable joy, unfailing seal, weapon of faith, shield against all the deeds of the evil one to those who are sealed by this oil. May those who be sanctified with this oil and those who are anointed by this be not caught by the enemies. When they stand before you at the day of the judgment, let them shine like the stars of the sky in the greatness of your saints. May they be received in the eternal dwelling place of the righteous ones according to your genuine promise. They may be counted with the firstborn whose name are written in heaven. You are worthy of glory, praise and reverence and dominion with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen." The Promion, or the introductory prayer, is very rich in Christology, and the nature of the Jesus Christ is profoundly affirmed in the following prayer. Again, I quote from the prayer book. "Glory to the Lord, who is self-existent, eternal, self-illuminating, and makes shining all nature, one who turns everything to you out of your love, towards the nature of life, source of all blessings, great and mighty, rule everything by the power of your word, inexplicable by anyone, King of kings, Lord of lords, ruler of rulers, one who makes the crown known as one in essence, you are worthy of praise, thanksgiving, etc. at the time of the consecration of Holy Moron and all the days of our life, now and forever." The first part of the Sadra, or the series of prayer, there is a detailed explanation of the economy of salvation of Lord Jesus Christ as given below in the following prayer. I quote, "Lord Jesus Christ, who is the King of all, you be to us the Son of Righteousness, incomprehensible by our minds, illuminating all of creation. You are, after completing all the creation, created human being from the earth. You honored human by your image. You adorned your creation with your greatness. You appoint human for spiritual service. You united them with the heavenly host. You adorned them with the shining priestly crown and clothes, royal attire. You adorned them with all beauty and prospered with your honor and splendor." In the second part of the long series of prayer, the effects of anointing with the Holy Moron and sound soteriology are elaborated in the following manner. "O Lord, we, the unworthy servants, beseech before you, have compassion on your worshipping community and have mercy on us. Sanctify this oil by the operation of your Holy Spirit. Make it complete and perfect. Lord, you be the robe of light, perfection of knowledge, freedom from all curse, liberation from slavery, forgiveness of sin, support in weakness, greatness of the Spirit, seal of watchfulness, unfailing weapons, way to the paradise, bridge laying to the place of gladness, ladder to heaven, door to the heavenly kingdom. Lord, make us the children of your heavenly Father, the inheritors of the mystery and your brethren. Confirm us in our love towards you. Fill us with the devotion towards you. Establish your truth in us. Confirm our faith in you. Adorn us with the upright deeds. Clothe us with the unblameable deeds. Enrobe us with girdle of maturity, the shoes of readiness of your gospel. We ascribe unceasing praise and thanksgiving to you and to your Father and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever." Unquote. Prayer of Consecration. The prayer of consecration, Metropolitan lays his hand on the jar and prays as follows. "God our Savior, have mercy on us. Shine your merciful face towards us and this oil. Sanctify this oil, O Lord, by your power and the grace of your only begotten Son and by the operation of your Holy Spirit. Because you are holy and giver of all good gifts, we ascribe praise and thanksgiving to you and to your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Again, it says, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Here the prayer for the consecration of the holy oil is addressed to the Trinity, and the invocation of formula for consecration is in the name of the Triune God. It is the practice of the Syrian Church that all proclamations and formulae of sacramental consecration is in the name of the Trinity. It affirms the Trinitarian faith of the Church. Conclusion. Anointing with the Holy Moroni is a sacrament established in the Church to keep the believers firmly in faith with the help of the Holy Spirit. In the churches with West Syrian liturgical tradition, Moroni is applied after the baptism on the forehead and other parts of the body of the candidate. Moroni is also poured out into the baptismal water as a sign of sanctification of the water. The Holy Moroni is applied to consecrate the church and the altar and the tabelito. The formula given in the post-baptismal anointing of the candidate is as follows. So-and-so is anointed with the holy oil or moron as a sign of the gift of the given to true believers in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. According to Sebastian Brock, olive oil is very closely associated with the Holy Spirit in the Syriac literature. But this is because oil was understood as the ideal conductor for the power of the Holy Spirit to Ephraim. To Ephraim, this oil is dear friend of the Holy Spirit. It serves him, following like him, a disciple. Moroni is the perfecter of the gift of the Holy Spirit and typifies the Holy Spirit, says Severius of Antioch. Syriac commentators also point out that Moroni symbolizes Christ the Messiah, the Anointed One. The oil is one of the more important symbols of the Holy Spirit, according to the early tradition. It confers on the baptismal candidate the royal priesthood, as practiced in the Old Testament, anointing the priest and king. Pouring out of the oil or the holy moron on the baptismal water and anointing after baptism combines both as a sign of the gift of the Holy Spirit. Athanasius says the moron makes the baptismal baptized a sharer in the anointing of Christ himself received on his body, and as a result he becomes a sharer in Christ's body, Ephesians 3 chapter verse 6. Dedication of the church with holy moron takes place in the following order: the altar, the sanctuary, the nave, and the baptistry. The purpose of the dedication or anointing is sanctification, renewal, cleansing from all transgressions and uncleanness. The baptistry is anointed for the holiness and renewal of the believers. The anointing of the moron is done by the priest who represents the church. It is the church who has sanctified the moron. The authority of consecrating holy moron is vested with the bishops in the respective areas. This is a sacrament of the unity of the church. The ecumenical nature of the sacrament is reflected in the fact that moron use is the same as the fellowship evolved also is same. Thank you very much for your patient listening. Thank you.